Hello, name is Shug, 57 years old, I'm a Taurus, I'm a hammock camper, and I really don't care how I dress.
So today we're basically going to be talking about this ridge line right here that goes on the hammock. What that does, essentially, is it creates sag in the hammock, and sag is this, what you see in the hammock right here. Sag. I've been keeping up with what people have been asking about on hammocks, what I see on YouTube, what I see on hammockforums.net, and a couple of other camping sites. And I see that people that are new to hammocks get a little confused about ridge lines, what they're for, how do you attach them, do you need them? So hopefully I'll just answer a little bit of that for you today, because I am Shug. I am the hammock expert. So why a hammock ridge line? One is it's setting the sag of the hammock. So when you attach it between two trees and pull your hammock tight, the ridge line causes your hammock, like I'm pulling on it here, and my hammock stays the same way. If I didn't have the ridge line, my hammock would pull up like so. Also, you can put a ridge line organizer on here. I hang my knife up here at night. But one of my favorite things I use it for when I'm changing clothes, I'm putting pants on or my boots off and put my hand on it to kind of balance myself when I'm up under my tarp or standing under porch mode. I mean, I can stand like this for a long time. But sometimes when I've been hiking all day, I'm a little bit wobbly. So I just find it good to kind of have it like that. And remember, there's no rules to this stuff. You use it the way you want to use it, or don't use it at all. Your choice. Now my ridge line is about 8 feet long, 96 inches. That is my personal comfort level. They say the basic starting point is measure the length of your hammock and start at about 83%. Now that gets a little mathematical for me, but it is a good place to start. But don't lock in there. You're gonna have to try it. So tie your ridge line so that you can undo it and loosen it and then tighten it back up. And just lay in it a while and see if that feels good. Lengthen it 2 inches, shorten it a couple of inches, go a couple of inches at a time, and you're gonna find your sweet spot. Oh, sweet spot of mine, yeah! What I have on here is an adjustable whoopee sling ridge line. One end just has a simple bite on it that I just loop around my suspension right there. That would be the first end I put on right at the end of the whipping of my hammock. Now here's the other end, and that would just go over again. It's a whoopee sling, so here's the loop, and here's the constrictor part and the extra. And what I use is just a little slip knot here I made. It's just a little prussic knot that I made out of some cord. And I just slip that little prussic knot right up to my suspension. And that just keeps it from sliding off when I pack my hammock away. And you can get these adjustable whoopee sling at whoopeeslings.com, several other places. Make sure to look in the description box below the video, where I will have a lot of places where you can order stuff for the ridge line. I undid the ridge line, so it's just laying off to the side now. And you can see how differently my hammock is laying. Still comfortable. I'm still crawling here and lay back, and I'm not uncomfortable at all. Now, it did not adjust my suspension at all. But here's what happens. What happens is I can crank my hammock up where it's very straight. Now, there are a few people that like their hammock this tight. I, for one, do not. I haven't changed much. Your hammock is a little bit tippier this way. I mean, that's still not totally uncomfortable for me. But I missed my ridge line up there. And your hammock is definitely a little bit tippier. And your stress factors on your trees and your suspension, because your hammock is straighter, you have a little more stress pulling in than if your suspension goes up like that. CA. There you go. Hope that kind of explains that.
I just realized something horrible here. In showing you that, I put so much pressure on my hammock that I ripped old Green Bean. There was so much stress on that when I laid in there to show you, I have ripped my favorite hammock that has served me since 2009. Well, I guess that's the way it goes. But let me go ahead and hook that ridgeline back up, and we're gonna finish this lesson, even though my heart is a little bit sad right now.
Now, when I hang my hammock, I usually sit so my feet are just touching the ground like that. That gives me some maximum comfort. And because my suspension is up probably even higher, a little higher than 30 degrees, my ridgeline is not super tight. I can bend it a little with my fingers, but that varies from hang to hang. And because of the sag in mine, my ridgeline sits up pretty high. So when I'm sitting around in the hammock, it's not down in front of my face like this. So if you find your ridgeline down in front of your face, try bringing your ridgeline in and creating a little more sag. And that'll get your ridgeline up a little bit. Though some hangs it may still dangle down. Not a perfect science. Good luck to you on that. What I have here is some utility cord from REI. It looks like paracord, but it's not. It's not quite as stretchy. You do not want to use a real stretchy cord like 550 paracord for your ridgeline because it will stretch. But if that's all you got, go ahead. So what you want to do is you want to tie a bite in one end. And what that really is just taking your cord, looping it like that, and just sort of making a knot like that. All right, it's just sort of a loop right on the end of the cord. Okay, here's what we're gonna do now. We're gonna take that bite, take our line, just run it through that loop. And now we have that over the end of our suspension. We're gonna go down our hammock here. And again, measure your hammock and go for about, start it at about 83% of the length of your hammock. I'm not gonna really do that right now. I'm just kinda going here, creating a loop. Now what I'm gonna do is I wanna go around my suspension. I've got a lot of line here, so this is gonna be a little fiddly. But I'm gonna bring it over, and I'm gonna kinda do what Jeff always did, is sort of do the Hennessy knot. I'm gonna wrap this way. Now I gotta bring all that line around because I have so much extra. I should have cut that off, but I didn't wanna cut it. I come back this way. So see what I'm doing here is I'm just crossing under, going around. I'm gonna pull the line around just so I don't get all tangled. Go around behind my suspension, come around it, bring it all around to the front again. Okay, I'm gonna come under like this, go around, just something like that. And I do 4 or 5 knots, and I'm just gonna come here and make a couple of slippery half hitches just to hold it. So what you'll wanna do is lay in your hammock, get on your angle, see how you feel, see if that feels comfortable. Do you feel comfortable in there? You know, if you wanna tweak it a little bit, come down here, make yourself a little mark right there with a little piece of tape or something, and pull it in a little bit or let it out a little bit, and tie it and retie it until you like it. And when you found your sweet spot, just tie it off and you're pretty much done. It's that simple. Ridgeline. Do you want one? Do you not? I don't know. I'm not really you. Do you need one? Not really. I like having one. It's just another option in the world of hammocking. And I love mine. I would never go without one. But I can bend it with my fingers a little bit, and that's about where you want it. And when I sit up, it's above my head. Now, you serious about hammocks? You got a lot of questions on it? Get yourself a copy of this right here, The Ultimate Hang. Go to their website, theultimatehang.com. I will put the link below in this video in the description box. It is the definitive book on just about everything you need to know about hammock camping. I'm gonna answer about 2 questions for you if you ask me. Other than that, I'm gonna tell you to start doing your own research. You wanna research it? Right there is your research treasure trove of intel, The Ultimate Hang. Don't make me tell you twice. Don't make me tell you twice. All secure in Sector 7. Woo, buddy. Woo!
Yeah.